What's going on, everyone? This is Tamil, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to create a Pinterest business account. So if you have a business where you want to promote your website, or you have a blog that you want to drive traffic to, then Pinterest is definitely the place to be. I'm going to show you how to set up that account, and then I'm going to walk you through some things that's involved with having a Pinterest business account. Now, if you are on the home page of Pinterest, then what you want to do is you want to go and click the sign up button right here in the right hand corner. And as you can see down here at the bottom, it says create a free business account. Now, I will say this, when I started out on Pinterest, I did not have a personal account. So I started out with a Pinterest business account. But if you have a personal account, then it just makes it even easier. You can log into your personal account and you can switch from, you know, your personal to your business account. But this tutorial is if you do not have a Pinterest account at all and you want to, you know, sign up for a free business account, you can do it this way as well. What you're going to do is you are going to click where it says create a Pinterest business account, and you're going to go through, and all you have to do is create your email, put your password and age here. So of course that's important, I guess, for them. Okay, so let's walk through those steps. I'm going to use this. I'm going to just create a random password just so that we can go through this, and then I'll just put something like, and then we can create. Once you create this, it's going to walk you through some steps right here for you to start with. So one of the things on building your personal or your business profile is branding your name and putting your website in. So these are some things that you can do. So first, to begin with, we're going to start off with, you know, building your profile. So you can put your brand name here, and I am just going to say that it is Lovely Life Designs, and we can use that. And then you can, if you have a website, of course, obviously you do, you're going to want to use that. And then I am going to use lovelylifedesigns.com. And then from here, you want to fill out the rest of this information. Now, if you want to put a profile picture here, you can, or you can skip this section. So you can either do that now or you can do it later. I'm going to show you how you can also do this later, because this one right here is going to be a dummy account for me. I just want to walk you through the actual steps. So let's go to the next page. Now, this right here wants you to describe your business. What is the focus or the brand of your business? And from here, you can click any of these that pertains to your business. So if this is a, you know, do-it-yourself or a travel business, or, you know, any type of educational business, then you can do that as well. For the sake of this, I'm just going to say that this is design and arts. Now, for this section right here, it's asking, what are your goals? Pick up to maybe like three of them. So it says you can update these in your settings at any time, and I'm going to show you where the settings are where you can update them. But what's your goal? So is it to drive more traffic to your site, or is it to sell more products? It just gives Pinterest an idea of where your business is going. So afterwards, we click next. Now it says to describe your business, get customized recommendations for your design. So if you're not really sure about this, then you can just pick I'm not sure, or you can choose any of these. So it says customize your recommendations based on your details. So mine, of course, is blogging. So I'm just going to pick blogger and move to the next one. But you can pick, put online retailer, you know, what is your business about, contractor or service provider. You want to choose one of these right here and then go to the next step. Now it says, would you ever be interested in running ads on Pinterest? Now, this is the great thing about having a Pinterest business account, is because you can run ads. So if you choose to do so, then you can say, yes, I'm interested in advertising. If not, then you can just click no. And if you're not sure right now, you can always go back and look. So then we're going to go to the next one. So it says, where would you like to start? So I'm not going to really go into details with this right here. I'm going to show you how you can get to the actual homepage, because you can skip a lot of this, but this is mainly for ads. So I'm just going to click out of this. And it's going to bring you to this section right here. With that being said, I'm going to actually go over to my account so that you can see what I'm doing. All right, so here I am inside of my account right here. And I have a fairly new account in a sense, but I just began marketing my business and, creating pins and things like that. So my views, I'd probably say after a good month or so, they're just picking up a little bit over like 299. I'm putting together a marketing plan at the moment. So this is how you're going to end up in a business hub. And the great thing about having a business hub is it shows you analytics. And so here are analytics that I have right here. I've got some pins already that are generating impressions. You can easily look at this stuff. Of course, you know, when you put together a marketing plan, it's going to be something that can help you drive even more traffic. This is fairly new for me in terms of just promoting my pins and promoting my blog in general. Okay, so what I want to do is I want to take you to the settings page because I want to show you how to set some things up. So if you go over here to where this arrow is and you click settings, this is where you're going to end up at. Now, there are a lot of different things that you can do, of course, with a Pinterest business account. And one of them would be to, you know, make sure that you have your name in place, a little bit about yourself or your business. And you want to be able to use keywords that display or talk about what your business is about. So my website is mailboxmoneyblog.com and it's already in my domain name. So I use that in my title and it's blogging tips plus make money online. And so you can add that in at the top. And I'm going to show you exactly where you're going to find this stuff at. This is how this is going to be set up. So next, what you want to do is you want to put a little bit of information about your business, you know, about yourself, and make it fun and make it exciting. Just tell a little bit about yourself and who you're about. As you go through this settings section, you can add additional things. So for right now, you can add your website, you can add your username, you can add a lot of these different things. So a lot of this stuff you can just pretty much fill in yourself. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back over here and I'm going to go to the home feed. So now what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go back to the business hub. But what I want to do is I want to show you, if you click on the little image over to the right, which typically would be your profile, then this is what you will end up seeing. So I've got some pins that I already have uploaded here, and then I've got my boards and more pins that I'm adding to my boards. And this is what it looks like. So they have all these pop-ups. This is how it would look. Now on this page, yours will be, of course, empty. And in the background right here, I have my logo. So you can easily just upload your logo by clicking this. And then I always suggest that you put a profile picture of yourself here so that people can see you as a real person. And, you know, just to be able to see, you know, that you actually exist. You're not hiding behind the computer. For this section right here, these are all the sections that I showed you in the settings that would show up. So of course, this right here is your title. And I want to add a note here because I think this is very important, especially if you're not familiar with keyword research. You need to make sure that you are adding in familiar keywords. And you want to use keywords that people are already searching for. So if your business is about blogging and blogging tips, and maybe it's about a travel blog, then you want to have the word blog inside of your title, and you want to have the word travel. Now, if you want to get ideas, the best thing to do is to go up to the top where I just clicked the search, and you can search. Well, we want to search all pins, not mine, but you want to click here, and from here you can type in different things like travel blog, and it will give you other people's pages that are coming up. So if I type in travel blog, and you can see how theirs is written, and it gives you ideas. So you can check out other people's pages to get different ideas. And these that you see right here are keywords. So these keywords are keywords that people are typing in. It's no different than Google in a sense, because Pinterest, you know, it basically has its own search engine and things like that. You can use these type of keywords inside of your title, inside of, you know, your about section. You can use those keywords there. So this really is the basis of your setting up your Pinterest business account. There are some things in your Pinterest business account that is unique compared to just a personal account. And I want to share with you that too, which is Rich Pins is one of them. Of course, the analytics account is another one. And Rich Pins is something that you may want to apply to. I don't want to get too into it right now, but it really makes your pins stand out because it gives more information on your pins. So let me go back to the profile section and show you. If you hit the edit profile, let me go back for a second. I'm going to show you where you can find the Rich Pins. Okay, so let's go back to the setting page really quick so that I can show you where you can do more of your setting up. Now, one of the things that you, and I'll get back to the Rich Pins in a second, but one of the things that you want to do since you have a Pinterest business account is you want to claim your website. And that's easily done by just, you know, putting in your website here, just making sure that they will verify it themselves. That's why you see this check mark here. So you want to claim your website. And another thing you want to do is you want to go ahead and you want to add in your email address just so that you can, you know, fill out your profile. Now, some of this stuff is not going to show up in your profile, so don't worry about if you don't want your email to show up. That's completely fine, but make sure that you fill out everything. So guys, this is pretty much the basis for your Pinterest business account. And I already set up my Rich Pins account. Like I said, I'm not going to go into too much detail here about Rich Pins. I'll probably do a video on it in the future on how you can set up your Rich Pins account. It's not very difficult to do, but I can definitely show you guys how to do that. All right, and lastly, guys, I want to show you one other thing that you're going to find extremely important to do, and I suggest that you do it early on, is that you want to claim your account. So there are some things that you may want to claim, which is maybe like a YouTube channel or maybe an Etsy site, or like as you see right now, mine is Mailbox Money Blog. That's why you saw the check by it. But I would suggest that you go through and you claim them as soon as possible. Then that way that you have all of these things attached to your Pinterest profile. So it's a really good thing to do because all of the integrations that Pinterest has really can help your business out a lot. So you definitely want to make sure that you're able to, you know, get all of these together and set your business account up so that it's ready to drive more traffic and to get more people viewing your profile. All right, guys. So that is it. That is how you create and set up a Pinterest business account. I think starting off with a Pinterest business account is extremely important because it sets you on a path of being able to promote your business. You look a lot more serious to people. You can really drive traffic with Pinterest. Make sure that you subscribe to my channel so that you can get more blogging tips, more tips on how to start and grow your online business. I, of course, have a YouTube channel. Of course, I'm on YouTube, and where I'm constantly creating videos and tutorials about things that I do in my own business. Then that way, if you want some tips and strategies on how to get your business going, you can definitely check out my channel. If you got value out of this video, then make sure that you also check out another video that I have, which is for Tailwind. So if you are going to start building your business with Pinterest and you're uploading pins, then you're definitely going to need to know how to create and set up a Tailwind account. So guys, make sure that you check out that video as well. All right, guys, thanks for watching. I'll see you on the next video.